Brent Huffmann is, I like how these things work out in the end. I saw a piece that Brent, who's a professor at Northwestern University, he posted. He's a filmmaker, he's a professor, but he posted his opinion on CNN, and it got huge coverage, and, you know, followed things on cultural heritage and archaeology and beautiful images and so forth. And I just emailed him, and we started a conversation like that. He is here to present his work and in Afghanistan, and it is, you know, very compelling. Also got his start funding on an online platform called Kickstarter. And at the same time, we at the Institute had our own Kickstarter campaign that was successful. So we already had something in common. And we're very glad that he's here with us today as well.
So the two sides is pretty self-explanatory, but there's a couple of things that you wanted to sort of convey to Brent before we move on. So Mes Aynak is actually located relatively close to the top, which makes it really an ideal site to preserve, because it's relatively easy access to get to the site, especially with Greg. So it's actually the point in a little red cross. It's about 35 miles southeast of Kabul. The unfortunate thing is it's located in Logar province, which is sort of at the heart of the Taliban country. It's very dangerous. As you see, the Afghan archaeologists are threatened. The site's been attacked by rockets. The Chinese company's been attacked by rockets. Quite a bit of historical significance of Mes Aynak. The study has just started. You know, there's been sporadic studies since 2009, but some significant things have been discovered. So there's this 2,000-year-old Buddhist city that archaeologists are excavating right now, but they've just sort of started to discover remnants of earlier periods. So they found pottery that's dated 4,000 to 6,000 years old. So Bronze Age material is underneath the Buddhist city. This is a reason why the archaeologists need more time to work at Mes Aynak to be able to excavate these older layers that are there. It was a major hub on the Silk Road. So learning more about Mes Aynak could redefine, you know, the history of the Silk Road. Redefine Afghanistan's importance, you know, influence throughout the Silk Road, influencing Pakistan, Iran, China. Residents of Mes Aynak were also mining for copper, so there's ancient mining techniques that we could learn from at Mes Aynak with further study. And then recently, was really excited to me. They started to find these ancient manuscripts buried within the stupas, the temple structures, and they were just sort of starting to discover these items and study them. That was their last. This is a full-length figure that was saved from Mes Aynak, a statue of a devotee to the Buddhists. When I was there in December, I saw this for the first time. This is a skeleton of a woman that was discovered who had died next to this stupa. The skeleton has actually turned green because of the copper in the area. As the video sort of suggests, and as my personal opinion, this is very bad for Afghanistan. This deal with this Chinese company, I think, is bad for the future of the country. I think resources are undervalued. There's massive corruption on the Chinese side and the Afghan government that is hurting the steel. One thing that the video doesn't talk about is that there will be just massive environmental devastation at Mes Aynak. So not only will this ancient city be destroyed, but you'll have sort of permanent destruction, environmental destruction. So experts I've talked to compare it to the open pit copper mine in Butte, Montana, which now is a Superfund, which is a designation for an environmental designation for a site that's so toxic, you know, told you can't even step foot on it. You know, it's dangerous to even, you know, step onto the ground. And at Montana, there's actually a lake that's permanently toxic. Famously, there was a migrating group of geese that landed in the lake and instantly died. It's that toxic. So that's the same thing that's going to happen to Mes Aynak, you know, if they mine in this very destructive way. MCC is partnered with a company called the Jiangxi Copper, and within China, they've created what have been called inside China as cancer villages, where people that, you know, drink the water that are sort of in a close proximity to the mine have gotten cancer or are dying. Local villages will be destroyed, so if you got a chance to watch the longer video. I interviewed locals in Logar province that were forced to move. They're now very angry about losing their homes. Some of the homes were maybe have a 500-year history or older. This very rushed rescue archaeology is destructive. The archaeologists who I admire the work that they're doing are, because of the very limited amount of time, they've only got until June. They're basically destroying structures to see what's inside them, or destroying something and take it apart to try to save it. And with more time, you know, they would have to do rescue archaeology. They could do a more detailed study. And my biggest fear is that this sets a precedent that this is how mining will be done in Afghanistan. That you, if there's an archaeological site, you force the archaeologist to rush through it. That research is undervalued. That you'll have this environmental devastation. So in part because of some of the work I've been doing, I've been interviewed on CNN. I've written about this issue, and other groups in the United States have also. About this to try to spread the word. There has been an international outcry to try to save this site, especially in Buddhist countries. Thailand, people actually, as you can see here, made homemade signs, protested outside of UNESCO in Thailand. We have an official petition. They got students to line up to sign the petition. If you're interested in helping, there is a petition here. That's hard to write down. Maybe it's a good long URL link there. But we've got almost 70,000 signatures to try to save the site. And then there's an official Facebook page to raise awareness, spread news about the site. The site was actually supposed to be destroyed in December, actually on Christmas of this year. And because of this international outcry, because of this pressure, the Ministry of Mines agreed to give archaeologists 6 more months, so the new deadline is June. So the good news is the government's listening. If we put pressure on them, if we spread awareness, they will listen, they will potentially give